Good evening, hockey fans. Welcome to tonight's game presented by TSTV in conjunction with CMNtv. I'm Phil Serafini here with John Marola. Tonight's varsity hockey game features the visiting Avondale Yellow Jackets versus the Troy Athens Redhawks. Avondale is coached by Scott Dockett, and Athens is coached by Joe Baroni and Tony Baroni. Athens is currently leading the Oakland Athletic Association White Division with 15 points. They have a two-point lead over their crosstown rivals from Troy High after skating to an exciting 2-2 tie last Saturday. Avondale is currently in third place with 12 points. They handed Athens its first loss of the season when they met for the first time in December, so this should be an exciting matchup. Avondale is led by number 5, Emmett Wagner, who has 42 goals and 25 assists combined for 67 points, and number 14, Nick Poplars, who has 25 goals and 32 assists for 57 points. Athens, meanwhile, is led by number 19 senior defenseman Brandon Goods, who has 19 goals and 15 assists for 34 points, and number 13 senior forward Griffin Roschlow, who has 12 goals and 21 assists for 33 points. This should be an exciting game. Athens has a lot to play for with just one league game left after this one. They win tonight, and on Saturday against Bloomfield, they will win their third division championship in their first since the 09-10 season, I do believe.
Yep, 08-09 and 09-10. We went back-to-back, and we took two white division championships, so should be exciting to hopefully see us pulling out this year.
Well, of course, both teams also have state playoffs coming up as well, so they're interested in preparing for those games, and this should be a very entertaining contest. Troy Athens has won one in the last two games. They've got a tie against Troy High in their last game on Saturday, 2-2, and they beat Birmingham Unified 5-0 in the game before that. Avondale is 1-1 in the last two games with a loss to Troy High and a overtime win against Sterling Heights Stevenson. Athens is getting ready for the face-off. Their players are all coming out to center ice, and Avondale is just leaving their net. Get this game going here momentarily.
John, it looks like that Athens got to take care of number 5 and number 14. They've got all the points for this team, practically.
14 is very good for Avondale. He does a lot of the work down low. 5 likes to float high, and he takes passes from in the corner from 14. So they definitely have a duo that seems to be working for them, and, you know, it's how they're getting a lot of their points.
We'll see that Athens won the opening faceoff, and they're chased back into their zone. Here comes a reverse coming out the center. They're entering the Avondale zone, putting a hard forecheck on him. Avondale's going for a bit of a change. It gives him a little time to make a move in this puck. Puck seems to be bouncing a lot early on. They're having a tough time controlling it. Both teams can't seem to settle it down in the neutral zone right now. So Dokotora gets one forward to Hill. He'll break in with that. He's just broken up. He's run into a lot of traffic there. He's coming in by himself. Here comes Brandon Goods coming through the middle and into the zone. And he lets one rip, but I do believe it hit somebody before it got through the goalie. Avondale's goalie is Nicholas Senkowski. Much like Troy Athens, they've got one goalie, so they ride him hard. Troy, of course, has got Jeff Marola. He's played terrific for Athens all year. He's among the leaders, as you would expect, in many of the important categories for Michigan High School hockey.
He's had quite a few shutouts this year, including that 5-0 win against Birmingham on Wednesday, and a few Saturdays ago against Stevenson at the showcase. So he's been very strong as of late.
And that puck that's knocked out with a high stick will get a faceoff. Yes, I agree. He was particularly exciting against Birmingham. He had to make a number of terrific stops in that game.
Well, let's see if he can bring that magic to the ice tonight.
Got a faceoff to the left of Jeff right now. Control of that puck with Brandon Goods moving up to the wing. He's going to cycle it back down. Griffin Rochelot's got the puck and he's making a move at the line. He's got some nice moves generally. He's a pretty slick skater.
They couldn't get that shot through to the net, and Avondale ends up clearing the zone.
Yeah. Yeah, it's going to be an icing come all the way back down. Number 13, Griffin Rochelot, did a good job of creating some room out there, but there was a few too many bodies in front to get that through to the goalie. Number 17, Trevor Henson on the puck in the corner. He's coming all the way back around the defense. Keeps it in with a good pinch. And Trevor's back on the puck in the corner.
Here comes Wagner. Player we've been talking about. He has a lot of points for Avondale. Bringing it into the corner for them, but cut short by McMicking.
He did a nice job cutting him off there, that's for sure. We've got the two sophomore defensemen playing out there together against this line. Got to be careful with these boys. He's 14. Nick Poplars, of course, plays with Wagner. He's out there as well. A little bit of action in front, but Jeff Moll isn't able to make the stops and get that puck out of there. Pace to the game to start with. Athens is having a little bit of a hard time getting moving, but here they come up ice now. Ooh, that's a bit unfortunately ran into the referee skate.
way up in front. Oh boy. It's a poor mistake at the blue line by our defenseman to give that up to them. It was a fine how do you do to Jeff facing a breakaway early in the game. He was up to the task. Trying to wake him up early, I guess. I suspect he'd prefer not to. Good rush coming in the zone now by Griffin. He gets cut off, though. The miscommunication. I don't think that Kosnak's defensive partner realized he was going off for a change. Griffin with a nice play at the blue line to get the puck in. He couldn't get that puck to settle down. I do like the way that they stand up to the Avondale players right at the line, though, and don't give them anything coming in. Oh, no, we're coming out. Oh, that's going to be offsides. Oh, Goki went about a mile wide off on that one. He tried to get back, but even as tall as he is, he couldn't get that leg back over the line.
A little too quick for Griffin.
Faceoff was won by Athens. Back to Mark Zielinski, who put it right back in the zone, and I believe he's going to do that again. Get in there with a forecheck to chase it down. Here comes Poplars up the right wing. That's a shot goal. A nice save by Jeff. Oh, and he keeps it out. Whoa. That was Mark Zielinski with a very nice play to come back and keep the puck from crossing the line there. I agree wholeheartedly. He actually did a good job of getting in the way of number 14, Poplars, so that he couldn't go in any farther, so he had to take a little bit of a long-range shot and then got back in behind Jeff to keep it out. Oh, there we go. Poplars had another shot at redemption here and flew it over the net, so puck's going to be out of play, and we're going to have the face-off outside. I say this was a little bit of the problem with the Troy High game as they were letting the shots off the face-off. The opposing team was going to do a little bit of a better job shutting them down. Good breakout pass by Goods there. Carradine rushing in hard. That's pretty much the status quo for him. I don't think he does anything slow. And they work it around the corner. Back out front to jab away until it goes in. Avondale is not too happy about that. They're yammering at the ref, but the whistle did not blow. And that puck is in the net. It was a good effort by the Athens players to keep jamming at the net. The ref right now, see what happens with the scoring play. Goal was scored by 10, number Dylan Katora. And that was good work. You can see it on the replay right here where he's just jabbing it in. The goalie did not have it covered and ended up swirling it off the net. In fact, that actually, the goal was credited to Dylan Katora with an assist to number 12, the sophomore co-captain, John Carradine. Well, that's not going to get him anywhere except out of the game. Number 16 picked up a penalty on that play, and fortunately for him, is now going to be out of the game. He's got a disqualification now as a result of his attitude in the box. Well, that's certainly a shame. He's their third leading scorer. That's number 16, Patrick Reedy. He's got 13 goals and 17 assists, but he won't be getting any more tonight.
Oh, I'm sure Athens will take the power play on that one any day of the week.
I suspect you're right. Now
Hills brings that in and lets that shot go on net. It's controlled in the corner now by Athens. Goods lets one rip through traffic, and he gets through, but I believe it hit the goalie more than he stopped it, I have to say. And there's John Carandang on the puck again. Nice play by Carandang. Smack the puck out of the air and keep it in. He's got some great hands. Oh, he really does. Ooh, another puck right in front. Goalie kept out. It's a good play. I believe they're going to bring that over to Goods on the point. Going to put that down low. Usually you're going to see a little bit of a cycle going on here. I wouldn't be surprised to see it come back to the point. Oh, that was a good play. Pressing the play on Jeff Marola apparently doesn't work too well because he can really shoot that puck. Goods is held up at the line, but the trailing player picks it up, and they score. Well, it was a terrific play, and that's the way you make people pay. You're going to take foolish penalties, you put them in the box, and then you score on a power play.
This play all develops from behind our own net. You see Goods get it up to Katora, and Katora just taking it wide, getting a shot on net.
He picked the far post on that one. I believe that's his goal.
That's two for him tonight.
Looks like he came to play. He didn't have much to shoot at, but he got it in the little spot that was available to him. Well, that's probably going to be another icing. Yes, it is. Trevor Henson was in on the forecheck and just made him dump it down the ice. It'll be another faceoff in the Avondale zone. This time you're going to see it to the goalie's left. It's our right as we're looking at it on the TV. Once again, Athens wins the faceoff. Get a shot on net, but it goes wide. Right back in with another shot that the goaltender, Nick Sinkowski, was able to stop. You see Costa Karabetsis on the forecheck again, causing the turnover. Trevor Henson throws it at the net. And Dylan Katora is one more time around the puck. Of course, he's able to net one more. He'll have the natural hat trick. Avondale will stop before they even get out, but now they're coming down the ice.
We got a short break, and he throws it wide.
Luckily, Chris Capaldi got back on that one and didn't allow him to path to the net. Avondale's back in their zone with the puck, and they're trying to work it out. Once again, Athens is right on the forecheck, causing the turnover. Austin DeMario is all over him. And you're going to see Alec Hill going after it. Great Alec Hill, the sophomore forward, brought that back out of the corner. He got a shot on net. Wasn't too tough for Nick Sinkowski, but as we've seen so far in this game, you just keep pushing on net and then go after it. You never know what happens. Face off was won by Athens, but it came back out. And there's a fortunate bounce up into
Alec Hill's face. There.
Yes, as he carried it in, he got hammered right at the line. Didn't seem to slow him down any, though. That puck goes off a skate, and it's right back into the Athens zone. You can see some jump in the step right here. Goes back up to DeMario on the far side.
Kosnak put that one low. He's allowing Athens to get the change. Bring a fresh set of forwards out there.
Nice little touch pass off the boards, and it's right back in the Avondale zone. And Athens is really putting pressure on early in this game.
Good hit by Golke to cough the puck up. Allow Marola to put it to the net. Marola keeps that one in. assistant captain for Avondale. I believe that's number 15, Spencer Felizzi. They take care of him in quick order. Nolan once again is forcing the early pass. Bit of a miscommunication on that one. A good poke check coming through the neutral zone. That's a good play to get around him, and they've
got
a
three
catch
on one.
Tell you what, that was a good opportunity. Looked like we got a little bit bunched up in the middle there, though. And a quick shot back in on Jeff Moeller that he easily handles.
Athens has drawn the penalty here. We got Trevor Henson to the box.
Now it's 2 minutes for a check to the head. We got him up a little bit high, obviously.
Good save by Marola.
Looks like he's cracking the puck well tonight. Of course, he did against the Troy High Colts the other day, too. That was particularly impressive. On Saturday, he seemed to know where the puck was going to go before Troy knew where the puck was going to go. That's a good clear out of the zone, and they'll get a change. Griffin Marshall on the forecheck, and he is oftentimes relentless when he's in this role.
Griffin's a very good skater, and he's very agile, so it's hard to get away from him sometimes.
He's out there with number four, Grant Golke, as the forwards. He's a big body. There's a shot on net that Jeff usually turns away. Check in the corner to free up that puck. It's now on their feet. Mark Zielinski is playing tough on that Avondale forward. And he's gonna wish he hadn't done that, though. He's going to get 2 minutes from a check from behind. That player turns his back. You've got to let him go. Tough to do in the heat of the moment, though.
Well, Poplars was very strong in the puck down low after passing goods, and he passed Zielinski a couple times there, so I think Zielinski just got fed up with getting worked down low. So
he controlled the first couple, I think, but I do believe he had enough. I agree. He got two for the cross check, and you see now that they've got a two-man advantage. Unfortunately, it's going to be for a pretty good stretch. So the Athens penalty killing. I don't want to jinx them, but they have been pretty good lately.
They look very good right now. They're keeping them outside, not giving them a lot of space. We got Trevor Henson out of the box, so we're going to get that fourth guy on the ice, and John Carandang. So hopefully they can box him out here.
Oh, that was close to being a breakaway. Actually, they had one man back, but it would have been one-on-one.
There's Cosman with a big hit in the corner.
That's the way to stand in there and take one for the team. He'll stop that puck before it got to the net. Good pressure. Good pressure. The puck goes all the way down the ice. We'll switch some of those penalty killers now.
Got just under a minute left in the power play for Avondale. Just maybe one or two shots on net for them. So Athens has been putting good pressure on them.
I think you hit the nail on the head with that comment. They have really done a good job of keeping them outside. They're not allowing anything in the middle.
Nice poke check by Jeff Miller to get the puck away from the front.
He's got a very active stick, that's for sure. Oh, we've got a 2-on-2 developing. A shorthanded opportunity. Sienkowski turned that aside.
Oh, Karen Dang with a beautiful takeaway. I'll tell you what, that was Datsuk right there.
Oh, it really was.
Oh, it just generates a terrific chance right there.
There were a couple of shots on net for Athens that were all from the hard work of John Karen Dang.
Well, and you wonder why he's named the co-captain as a sophomore. That tells you everything you need to know right there.
He's a very hardworking, dedicated player in practice, too. So, you know, the team really looks up to him for a lot of leadership, both on and off the ice.
Once again, number five, Edmund Wagner, their leading scorer for Avondale, is trying to break in, but they stopped him again before he got even a shot off. They're doing a good job so far this game of bottling him up, but you know he's going to get some opportunities before it's over.
He always finds a way, just like any good scorer does.
Scorer once again is on the forecheck, causing another turnover. Puck back to the point. We did a little skating around.
Comes 19 for Avondale, who seems to be a defender for them. He's been very active with the puck tonight, creating quite a few rushes for Avondale so far.
He's got quite a few assists on the season. I think he's got 13, if I'm not mistaken, 15 points overall. Another save by Jeff Marola, who's clearly in the right position, fouling the puck well. Now, that was a pretty good play to control that puck by the Avondale player to keep that in. It was a bouncing puck. He went down and got it. Was a very exciting first period and a good period for Athens.
Before I started with CMN, I knew absolutely nothing about video production. I studied creative writing in college, not techie, not technical. There are a lot of different things that go into producing a video in a truck shoot situation. The truck shoots actually start way before the games or the concerts start. So we go out there a couple hours early, we set up. That involves getting all the cameras out, hooking them up to their proper cables, putting the cameras on tripods, putting them on dollies if necessary. Just holding a camera, getting comfortable with the camera. You think, you know, that all you have to do is point and shoot, but that's actually not what's going on. There's a lot more to it than that. I've had now the opportunity to be a technical director a few different times now, and that's when you're actually deciding which shots are being fed into the program live. And we have the shots from all those different cameras, and you have to look at them in real time and decide which shot you want to take and when. That kind of experience kind of rewires your brain, where you always need to be thinking about what shot is appropriate at this second, and then anticipating what shot is going to be appropriate in the next couple seconds. You know, when you're a technical director, you have to be assertive. And if you're not seeing the right shots that you want to take, you have to tell the camera operators. All these details go into producing quality video. It's mostly a volunteer effort, and the staff here understand that. And they're very patient, they're receptive to people that are learning, kind of fumbling, and you get guidance. So, you know, again, you can't learn this stuff just by reading a big, thick manual. You have to go out there, you have to get your hands dirty, and this is a pretty relaxed environment to learn all these things. My name is Ben Curry, and I'm an intern here at CMN.
Teams are starting to come back onto the ice for the second period. It was an exciting first period, and a good period for Athens. They were in line of jump in their step, really forcing the play on both ends of the ice.
Athens will come out here and hopefully pick up the tempo a little bit. They started off a little slow. You know, they got back into it through the period, and you know, usually their second period isn't their strongest, but maybe with the first period being a little bit slower like that, decided to flip it around on us tonight.
Well, it'd be good to see. As we said, this is an important game for them. Got just one league game left after this one. got 15 points. They're leading the division by two over Troy High, who has three games. So Athens clearly cannot afford to lose any of these last two games and expect to win the division. You can see them with the second half, or after the first couple minutes, I guess, from the first period, we get that after the rest of the way, they'll be just fine. Avondale, not surprisingly, is coming right back out with number five out there, Emmett Wagner. It looks like number 14, Nick Poppers, is on the other side.
Starting with Poppers and Wagner.
And number nine in the middle, Eric Kaczynski. He's got 15 points also, so he put the puck in the net and gets an assist. It isn't hard to believe playing with those two. Right out of the gate, Avondale's coming out strong. Get the puck right in the Athens zone. They've picked up the forecheck here. John Kierandang down in the corner to not let the Avondale players have anything to work with there. And put it right back into the Avondale zone. An initial shot popped up in the air.
Brandon gets picks that one up out of the neutral zone, tries to skate it in and gets picked off.
Well, it was number seven, Noss, and he made a nice play on him. Clearly did not pay a lick of attention to the puck and only watched the body and took him off the puck. That's pretty much what you have to do with Brandon because he's too slick of a skater and a puck handler. The minute you watch that puck, you're going to lose him.
Some defenders will know that even if you watch the body, it's very hard to get him. Very active.
He's made more than one person look a little silly this year. He seems to have that sixth sense. Once he makes the first move, he seems to already know what he's going to do on the second and third one. Got Brad Morley's line out there right now, and his assistant captain is a junior on a team filled with seniors, and it's been well deserved. He's played terrific this year. Yeah, right off the faceoff. Oh boy. We'd like to have that one back. I think he's bouncing on him a little bit. And we had an opening to shoot at. Well, that's a good play there. This out. Got Griffin Roschlow again coming up ice with the puck. He makes a nifty move to get around that defender. I suspect it's going to be icing. Yes, it is. Athens has those skilled players out on the ice. It is hard for the other team not to just take that thing and dump it out. Senior captain Costa Caravetsos line out there right now, taking the faceoff, which he wins, but it squirts past the defender. Mickey did a good job of getting back on that puck, and now Costa's back on it in the zone. Oh, it's a good pass right in front, and that was a nice play.
It was a nice development of the play with McMicken noticing that Serafini was covered, couldn't make the D-to-D pass, so he shot it up the boards. Costa picked it up and went into one-on-one with Katora. And Henson followed up and picked up that little pass he threw out front.
Speaking of that D-to-D, we just saw that right there. And now we're right back up ice again with Katora. Oh, he's looking for the third.
He's definitely hungry now.
That puck bounced over Serafini's stick of defense, and McMicken did a great job of following up on him. Oh, and he got a piece of him as he was coming in and knocked him off. But I think he's going to get called for a knee. more like a hip, but he's going to get the knee and go. Yeah, 2 minutes for a knee to knee hit.
He stepped up to take the body, and Avondale took one step around him, and all he could do was, other than let him go by, was stick that knee out and clip him.
We got a piece of it. We'll see if we can get another good penalty kill like we did the last couple.
We got a two-on-one developing here.
Oh, man, that was a nice play. Supermarshall came up patiently up the ice, just waiting for Carradine to get in position and set a beautiful pass across to him. Just couldn't finish it off.
Zielinski battling hard to get the puck. Pops out through to Wagner. Wagner throws it across.
Oh, Carradine picks
his
pocket,
picks
again.
It off.
Oh.
Loses it at his feet.
They're fortunate with that one because generally when he gets free, you don't catch him.
He's gone every time.
He's going to go for a change right now. I'm going to see Costa come out, the other captain. He makes a strong move right across the ice. Throws his body in front of it. Very, very unselfish player.
That shot by Avondale right there was an example of Wagner getting free in the high slot. Here we go.
Oh, nice play. I was talking before the game with one of the parents, and that kid has got a great backhand. It's somewhat unbelievable that this is continuing to go on. They didn't call that puck. They didn't call that a goal down at the other end. And now Avondale is down and scores. This is, quite honestly, somewhat, I don't understand what happened. I guess we're going to have to get an explanation on that one or see a replay. Sure looked like it went in the net.
Here it is right here. It's Washlow.
9-5-14.
Clearly in the net.
Oh, they missed that one bad. Well, that's a shame.
He clearly scored, and I suspect you saw a little bit of a let-up waiting for the ref to blow the whistle for the goal that was never called. As a result, instead of being 3-0, it is now 2-1.
Refs can't miss a call like that, especially when they got TVs in the ring.
That was a, it was blatantly in. It really, the goalie was not covering that one, and it was hard to understand how they missed that. You got three refs out on the ice, so it's a little difficult to get your head wrapped around that one. But regardless, it's 2-1. And that Avondale's goal was scored down at the other end by number 9, Eric Dudzinski, with an assist to, strangely enough, number 5, Evan Wagner, and number 14, Nick Poplars. And as always happens, when you see that goal scored, you see a little bit more pep in the opposing team's step. Goes up to Trevor Henson, who stays on the puck to Raggett. And he'll, pretty good wraparound on the arm of the Athens player. The ref lets that one go. It was an arm clearly off the stick and wrapped around Athens player there. Asnak does a good job of stepping up to keep that puck in.
Coast with a shot from the top of the circles. Puts it right into Avondale. Goalie's gut right there, trying to get it on net, hoping for a rebound, but Sinkowski absorbs the impact on that one.
Well, it was a successful play for them on Saturday against Troy High. That's how they scored both of their goals. Good play by McMicking to step up and keep that puck in. And you're going to see the same thing from Serafini now. Get back in and keep that puck in the zone. Ooh, that was a nice try for that tip from a tough angle. 3-18, Mike Abel smartly takes a look at D and sees that pass wasn't there and threw it back down low. Somebody's going to go after that puck, sitting there in the middle. Avondale dumps that in down low. You see Jeff Morla play that puck up. We said before in the first period, he can really shoot the puck around. And here comes Athens once again. Coast is coming in. And good forecheck again to get control of that puck. Coast from the middle of the ice. It's another shot on net.
Good pressure there by Athens to not only get the puck out of their zone, but in the Avondale zone and keep it from coming back out towards the blue line that we had the forwards picking up the puck before the defense and even had the opportunity to. So a lot of back check and a lot of moving back into their zone.
Yeah, those little shifts actually with the two sophomore defensemen out there are very important because they get some rest for the seniors and juniors. We're going to, I would suspect, eat up the majority of the time in the third period and probably the rest of this period.
Rolla with an opportunity that slipped right off his stick. He gives it back to Griff, and Griff buries it.
That goes to show you, you don't have to do it very hard. You just got to get it off quick.
I think with that one, you know, Griff was happy to finally get a goal that counts this time, too.
Well, that's true. That's really, unfortunately, his second goal of the game, but it's only going to count for one.
Face-off, as you saw,
and they're picking up the pace, trying to get that goal back.
Poppers right now, as you can see, is very frustrated after, you know, two good scoring opportunities, and it looks like he went wide on both of them. But he is definitely hungry to get another shot on net and, you know, hopefully hit the net this time.
Well, Avondale is clearly going to press the play at this point. And know they can't sit back against this team. We're going to watch them skate you into submission if you do that. Rochelle's back out there and on the puck once again. Not surprising. Here he comes out wide. And he tries to return the favor by throwing that back to the trailer. It's a good play. Very unselfish. He's on the puck once again. Here comes Costa getting that pass. And it is stripped from him before he can let it go. Good play up to Katora. He's going to be all over this the Avondale player in the corner. Yep, he
nice hit.
Oh, he laid a good hit on him.
Very nice hit. And gave Henson the opportunity to make a great play into the right into the slot in the Avondale zone. You get goalie Jeff Marola covering the puck here. Slow it down and get a line change for the Athens defenseman.
Just good play by Kyle Kosniak, keeping that man out wide. All he could do is bounce that off the backboards. Came right back to Jeff, and Jeff smartly covered it up. But interesting this year, you see that Athens has scored a lot of goals, but you don't have one player, any one player other than Brandon Goods, with very many goals. And he's got 19, and John Carandang's got 17, Brad Mill's got 15, Costa's got 14. It's just a well spread out offense. They've got three lines that can really all put the puck in the net. That's what makes them so difficult to play against, especially when they're passing the puck.
A lot of these other teams in the OAA White Division have realized that, you know, the team is very, very deep, not only in the offense but the defense as well. That it's, you know, it's hard for them to gain opportunities, and, you know, we have a strong goaltender backing them up as well. So it's not surprising that we've had such a successful run here.
You know, and Avondale, to their credit, actually has had a pretty good season as well. They have 14-6-0 overall, 6-4 in the league. So they're certainly no slouch. So turn over at center ice, they're coming back in. And smartly, once again, the defenseman takes the body. And it frees up the puck.
Griffin is now in the zone. He's going to wait for some players to catch up. That was a nice play by Hill with the little spin around trying to tuck it up top. So have that kind of talent on this team. Well, up front in particular, the underclassmen have performed pretty well. Really been a good distribution of juniors and sophomores to go with the nine seniors on this team. Puck seems to be caught in their feet. Nice defensive play by Capaldi. Once again, took the body. He's not gonna allow anybody to make a move on him. That puck got loose, but Griffin just couldn't get it out of his feet. I believe it went up into the net, and we're going to get a faceoff outside the zone, though, either way. Here, Batsos is in the center. Couture and Henson on this play. Faceoff goes back into the Avondale zone. I'm not sure that's a benefit to them because Karabetsis was on it very quickly. And the puck is now moving back into the Athens zone. Zielinski's going to get back and get to that puck first. He just misses the pass to the forward. Comes out, and Henson knocks that down out of the air. Takes a hard shot on net. Rebound out in front. Oh, that puck is still loose. Nick Sienkowski was fortunate to turn back around and put his hand over that one.
If you look at that play there, Katoro was very close to getting that third goal. Puck came out right in front, hit him on the stick, and goalie came out, was very active in playing that one.
Katoro's been on the puck tonight, that's for sure. Katoro, actually. I mispronounced his name. For a change right now, replaced by number 18, Mike Gables. The face off in the Avondale zone to the left of the goaltender. Back to the defenseman, but his shot went off the Avondale player. Somewhat soft shot on net. Jeff Moll steers to the corner. And we're right back into the Avondale zone. Good hard work down low. John Kiernan is skating on the puck. He's very hard to get off of it when he gets to it. Goods get control of that puck inside the Athens line and putting it up for his forward. And as a result, we're right back in the Avondale zone. Zielinski and Brandon Goods have been a defensive pairing for most of the last five or six games. Jeff Morola was fortunate to pick that one up out of traffic. Shot from number 19, Paul Mariani, from defense. He's very tough on that puck right there to get that back into the Avondale zone. Here comes number 5, Wagner. Again, it's a one and done, though. They're not getting a lot of second opportunities, Avondale. Brad Morola did a nice job of holding up the Avondale player. Allowed number 20, Serafini, to pick that puck up.
There goes a missed offsides by the referees again.
Boy, that led to a decent scoring opportunity, too.
I think if that one would have went in, the Athens coaching staff would have had some issues with them. So
somewhat hard to believe with three refs out here. Someone parked right on the line. That didn't get caught.
And a good save by Marola on Poplars.
Funny thing about that is all of that was set up by the missed offsides.
It really was. It's where it hits you, that one little call.
As a result, we now have a face-off to the left of Jeff Marola. Once again, won by the Athens centers. Pass off ice there. A nice little touch pass.
Oh, and Katora missed that third one again.
He's been all over it. By Trevor Henson, forcing the play in quickly. Doesn't allow Avondale to set up. Mickey got that puck in the corner right back up to Henson. He's going to charge up ice again. He's once again coming up with Katora. Avondale defender does a good job of taking the body right off the puck. Osnak kept that puck in at the line. As a result, he created that opportunity for John Karindak. A nice shot from the wing. That should be icing, and it is. Avondale was content to just put that over Katora's stick and get it down the ice. They're going to change up their line.
We got just under a minute and a half left to play in the second period here. Athens is still up on Avondale 3-1.
Much like the first, this has actually been a pretty quick period. It's hard to believe that it's almost over. The refs are not going to allow that late line change. Kostak put that in on net, and that's why you do it, nice and low. The rebound came right back out, and there was an Athens player waiting to just put that in.
Good face-off win by John Karindang. Get it back to Kostak. It looks like... Looks like Alec Hill is the one who put it in. If I'm not mistaken, take a look at that. Yeah, it was Alec Hill who put that in off the shot from Kostak.
Yep. So that's who took that face-off. He should get the second assist on that. But the first assist is clearly going to Kostak. And Alec Hill with Johnny on the spot right by the side of the net where you belong.
So I think that second assist is going to go to Karindang, who won the draw back. And a good glove save by Marola on Wagner.
That was fast. Keeper, but we have the advantage of the replay, and it was clearly scored by Alec Hill with an assist to Kyle Kostak, who shot the puck, and the faceoff win and second assist goes to John Karindang, number 12. He's got that puck in his feet, and he kicks that into the zone to keep it out of trouble. It's never a bad thing to have in the puck in the opposing zone and get in trouble that way. Tie up in the corner by the Athens defenseman. We got a nice spin away by Brandon Goods. Almost hit Roshlow, but here comes Brad Marola right on it. That's a quick feed. He goes down, gets right back up, and still keeps control of that puck. We've got about 6 or 7 seconds left here. Just need to keep them to the outside. Wagner tries to cut through, but he doesn't have enough time to do that. The whole period ends with Athens up now 4-1. Really, it should be 5-0. It really should.
Still upset about that missed call by the refs, but sometimes you don't get those bounces.
That'll take us to our second intermission.
I am brave.
I am faithful.
I am beautiful.
I am beautiful.
I am beautiful.
They are beautiful. I'm so excited because I see growth, I see potential. I see that they can love, that they can love themselves. When did you gain the understanding that you had self-worth?
Self-esteem isn't something we're born with.
It's something I have to develop.
There are many other programs out there that provide self-esteem tools, but our program is different. Reaching out to various communities and providing the workshops free of cost, A Beautiful Me is producing measurable results in young ladies' lives and in their communities.
We know we're made in God's image. We know we're loved. And when they leave our workshops and activities, they take with them tools that they can use out in their communities because they're more confident.
We're worth it.
I'm worth it.
I'm worth it.
I'm worth it.
They are worth it. We depend on people like you for support. Find out how you can make a difference. Visit TheBeautifulMe.com today.
Well, we're going to get ready to start this third period in just a minute. And before we get going, I think we probably owe the referees an apology. I think we definitely do. After talking to Joe and Tony Baroni, the head coaches of Athens, said it looked like it hit the left post on that breakaway. So it's almost positive that looking at this screen here that it looked like center of the net to me. But apparently we were wrong. So, well, as often happens, the refs generally do get it right, and they did get it right that time. And it was confirmed by another parent behind the net that it actually hit the post and popped out, although the goalie sure thought it was in as well.
He did too. He definitely stopped moving on that one.
So we've we'll offer our apologies, and if you watch this game, you'll know that, that we have been duly noted.
Although I still blame him for that one offside they missed.
We'll stand with that call. That one was correct. All right, here we go. We've got the puck coming all the way back down in the Avondale zone. And Trevor Henson, as he's been all night, is right back in on the forecheck.
Yeah,
I believe that went off the netting and came back in. Off in the other zone. It's chipped back out by Avondale and back down the ice. Trevor Henson, number 17, the senior forward, is first on that puck. It's a good active stick right there by John Carendan. Keep that puck from coming out in front. Athens has done a pretty good job of that so far, containing the Avondale players. Whatever chances they've had, they haven't had any second chances, really. So Brandon Goods with another rush up the puck. Nice job. Created an opportunity for his team. And that sophomore forward, Sean Serafini, picking that puck up and moving it into the zone. Something that I think that the Bronies would like to see him do a little bit more.
Roll throws that one out of play.
You can see him smiling out there. He knows he got that one just dead high.
I think he took it too literal when the coaches say high glassing out on that one, so. Oh. What a play by Avondale to get that one in the net.
It was a good play. Well, that was a good knockdown right there by McMicking. Nice confident play with conviction. Well, it bounces off that hip to go get the puck.
So
tell you, this sophomore defensive pairing is doing a good job of standing the Avondale players up in the middle of the ice, not letting them gain the zone. And speak of the devil, here goes McMicking once again and hammers one in, but I think it's just got out of play. See the Avondale player laughing as he's going over to the bench because I think that puck went in there. So right by someone's face as it was going in there. Gonna like the aggressiveness of that play though. Nice job by Chris Capaldi for getting on that puck. This has been a solid defensive pairing with Capaldi and Koznak really pretty much most of the year. They start mostly important games together and they eat up a lot of minutes. A couple of opportunities on a tough bounce.
Avondale tried to stuff it on that wraparound attempt and that didn't work for them. Neither did that shot out front either.
I have to say, I don't think that I've seen Jeff Morrow get beat on a wraparound this year. He's got a pretty good stick and he follows the puck really well. Puck goes back down for an icing and you'll have a face-off in the Avondale zone. Give both teams an opportunity to change their players. Well, we've got number 10, Dylan Katora, back out on the ice. He's been around the net all night. You know, he'll be looking for that third goal.
There goes Popper breaking through.
Oh, that's a good check right there by Katora. He's not going to let him get anywhere. Good move by Goods, strangely enough. Trying to weave his way out of that zone, but he gets stopped.
Well, he was somewhat able to redeem himself in that turnover by cutting the puck off and getting the Poplars in the slot.
Well, he's got an active stick.
And Poplars is going to get the call on that one.
It did look like he came down with the stick right on top of him. You can see he's not very happy about it, but it did happen. 14 purple elbow. He's going to call him 2 minutes for the elbow. Off back down to the Avondale zone for the Athens power play. They were successful on one already today. See if they can get another one. And looking that puck down hard. Down low. Oh, nice step up there by Koznak to stop that breakout. Just got that puck center ice, and now it's back by Henson to the defenseman for the feud in. Hill did what you need to do there when the puck's up in the air. He did try to glove that down, but it went over his glove and down the ice. Off here down to the right of Athens goalie Jeff Morrow. As has been the case more and more lately, you see that faceoff taken by Athens sophomore co-captain John Carradine. He seems to be eating up a lot of the important faceoffs. Good puck movement here. It's a good shot from a tight angle, though. Oh, that was a hard shot from the point. By Brandon Goods. He's got a quick, hard release. Just missed the net. Good move there. Give that to Griffin Rochelot, who's going to skate in.
think you're going to see what I think is... Oh, he throws that back. I do not have any idea how that happened. Griffin Rochelle was getting ready to do the Griffin loop, come back around the net back in front, but he decided to throw that one back at the net and ended up in behind the goalie.
There goes 13-9.
Alec Hill with his second goal tonight as well. So we have two players on the Athens roster that are both one goal away from a hat trick. That's true. That is Alec Hill getting the benefit of some hard work by Griffin Rochelle. Very unselfish to throw that back in front. And it resulted in an assist for him and a goal for Alec Hill. Second assist going to number 9, Brad Marola. Another hard worker. Never see him take a shift off. Good step up once again. And that puck's going to come right back in. And Hill's looking for the third down. He just barely missed the far side with that shot. It's a good wrist shot on the fly. Always a good move because it doesn't give the goalie time to set up. Good check just to knock that player off his feet. Take him off the puck.
It looked like Poplar's knocked himself off that puck.
That might be. He's very frustrated, you can tell, in the last probably period or so. Certainly culminated in the sort of a needless elbowing penalty that resulted in that power play goal.
Kosnak pinching with the puck, getting it deep for Athens. We got Golke moving in. Rochelle picks it up the top of the surface here. Gets it picked off by Wagner.
That's a good accurate stick by Wagner.
High stick. Another high stick here after Kerr Betzels caught that one on the shaft.
Looked like Avondale was going to touch that, but came back to the defenseman first, so we'll have the faceoff down in the Athens zone as a result of that. Good job on the faceoff by Kerbetsis there. Good active stick.
Very nice play by Rochelle. He's going to airmail that one and see if Karabetzels can beat Avondale D to the puck.
Well, he does indeed end up with it for a second and is kept in by a good active pinch by Serafini. Looks like somebody told him to get more aggressive tonight.
Ooh. Ooh.
Avondale player going for a hard cut around the net, clearly lost an edge and put himself into the net.
He's not very happy about that one.
Not so much. A faceoff to be outside the zone as a result of the Avondale player knocking the net off. Trevor Hensel with a nice little touch pass up to Karandang. Gains his own. Good pass over. Oh, right back in front. Wow. That's a good play. That puck ends up in the back of the net.
17-10.
Well, Trevor Henson's going to get that goal.
Tor with the assist there. He's doing hardest he can to get that third goal, but his hard work's paying off in goals for others, so I think he's happy with just that.
Seems to me that a second assist on that goal should have gone to number 12, John Karandang. He's the one that carried that puck up originally.
I believe so.
I think that's what the score is going to announce right here. Well, actually, that's a good reward for Trevor Henson. He's been working hard all night. Get that up to the forward. Well, Serafini's going to come up on a little bit of a rush there. Put that in a little bit harder, but oh, and I'll tell you,
I don't know if I can see him do that.
It was a nice play by Jeff Mola to track the puck there.
Yes, it was. It's a good back check to get back into that play. I've heard that Tony Brony in particular is wanted his younger defenseman to step up the play in terms of aggressiveness. We'll see if he thinks that that was a little bit too aggressive on that one. It would lead to a scoring opportunity by Avondale.
You know, playing for Joe and Tony for the past 3 years, I don't think Tony Brony will ever complain about you being too physical. So I think those younger defensemen throwing the body around are only going to hear a little bit of praise for that. As of late, the Athens D-Core has been a little bit on the softer side, so it seems like they've been picking it up this game.
They do seem like they've made a concerted effort to really step up the hitting and attack the puck in the neutral zone without letting the opposing team enter the zone.
A few of the players that you normally don't see taking the body are starting to throw it around, so it's good to see that they're making that improvement to play a little more physical. So come time that they play teams that do like to play the body, won't be as big of a shock to them.
Well, I'll tell you, that was a nice play coming into the zone, and very unselfish to get that puck back on a drop pass to Alec Hill. It's 6-1 at this point. It does look like they're going to try and get him that third goal, and I'm sure they'd love to see Katura get one as well. Katura. Oh, watch out now. Here comes Brandon Goods. Boy, he's got a quick release off the backhand or the forehand, doesn't he?
He really does. He likes to get into that flex and just let the stick do the work.
I've really seen a change in him over the last couple of games. He has been distributing the puck and really improving the play of his teammates. Not surprisingly, Athens has been on a good run since that's been happening. Right, Rochelot to walk the line over there and cut that over to his defenseman. They're going to wave that icing off. I think the Avondale player might have been thinking he was going to get hammered there. It looked like he backed off on that play into the corner a little bit. And as a result, Costa Karabetsis is right back down the ice with the puck. He tried to slide that over to Grant Golke, number 4. It was a good play, just didn't connect. Move in front by that Avondale player for the shot on goal, which Jeff Marola again is tracking very nicely. You can just tell the past couple games he's really seeing the puck well. Nice good hit by Golke. Oh no, he's going to call him for that one. See what he gives him on that one. What did you see, John?
It looked like he was just making a hit. I don't know if he caught him late or we got Griffin with the penalty here.
Oh, we got him with a high stick, I think. I think we were focused on the hit. We didn't see the high stick and the off the other side of the ice. Another shot from the point, which Jeff Moore calmly knocks away. Down from behind on the Athens defenseman, but luckily for Avondale, he wasn't by the boards. Well, Avondale's still looking for a power play goal here. You're looking at number 5, Wagner, out on the ice again. It looks like with 9-14, one more time. So that's Kaczynski, Poppers, and Wagner up front for Avondale. Those are their big guns. And to say, Tony Brony runs the defense during the games, showing a lot of confidence in some sophomore defensemen to put him out on this power, the Avondale power play for the penalty kill.
I mean, there's absolutely no question that they've been hitting bodies. They've been getting the puck out of the corner and up to the wingers, especially in this situation. You got both guys in the middle pushing guys out front and then the one in the corner.
That's a nice clear down the ice after some good job blocking shots, not letting him get through to Jeff Marola. Oh, once again, oh, that's a pretty play, but Trevor Henson, he's got some moves going there. Might have been one too many. It's a good move down ice, though. Up into the netting. That senior pairing on that defense now of Brandon Goods and Mark Zielinski to finish off this penalty kill. Done a good job. It looks like there's only about 25 seconds left in this power play. Good effort by Brandon Goods behind the net to get the puck out. Now he's going to rush it forward. He's got the wheels on. He's just going to keep going. He's going to forecheck it, press them. Wow. Oh, that's a beautiful play. Not only does he beat the man to the puck, he comes out of the out from behind the net with it and almost gets a wraparound. Full strength here. That's a nice knock away by Roland. A good clear by the Athens team. You see the you see Brandon Goods with the shove in front of Jeff Marola, clearly sending a message, don't touch the goalie. Marola clearly had the puck in his glove on that play. Avondale offender wanted to keep going and, you know, hopefully try to scrape it out and get a goal for them, but Marola's gonna play the puck on that one. Suspicion is if he thinks his boys are going to get control of it, he's going to keep that puck alive and keep the time ticking. We've got about 3.5 minutes left in this game. We've got a 5-goal lead. Terry might just be ready to go home, too. It could be. Behind the net with the puck, put it up to the forward. Nice little flip pass there too to get it by there, the Avondale offender on that play. Here you go with Wagner, right off the post on that one, and it stays out of the net. Oh, Wagner again with a one-timer, and the roll of stones him on that one. Yes, he sure did. The as they say, the goalie's best friend, in the post on the one, and then he stoned him on the second one.
Looks yes. Like that one's been going for both teams tonight.
As we discussed, you're going to see Wagner get his opportunities, and that's a giveaway right up in front. Now you can see that John Carradine gets some reward for his hard work with an assist from Alec Hill, number 8. Two sophomores.
Look right here, just an absolute silky play. Takes one move right, cuts to the other side, he waits for the goalie to open up the 5-hole, and he just slides it right through. Soft hands. Very quick, too. Another thing that he is very lucky to have.
Oof. Hard shot coming right in there, just misses the outside of the net, going far side. You can just see that Athens right now is just, they're just feeling it on offense. And Avondale's coming back down. Nice job by McMicking and Serafini to pick those players up, take the body, prevent any opportunity.
Rossell still in control of the puck after almost losing it behind the net.
Did a good job to pick that back up. Avondale's had a hard time containing him tonight.
There's a rush for Avondale, and McMicking with a very nice hit.
Marola's going to take that opportunity to pop that down the ice himself to clear the zone.
Just under a minute and a half here to play in the third period. Troy Athens leading Avondale with a commanding 7-1 score.
Well, one had to suspect that they were not going to give Avondale any opportunity to do what they did in the December when they handed them the first loss of the season, 4-3. They've really been on them from the get-go. Doing a great job once again, just like there, of attacking at the line and not letting them gain the zone. Couture coming in there for a chip shot at the goal, looking for number three with less than a minute left. I believe you're going to see him left out there. I'm sure he's more interested in making sure that the team wins, which is pretty much all assured at this point. But I'm sure he wouldn't mind getting that third goal for the hat trick.
Always nice to get that third one in the goal column for any player.
Great job once again by Goods to step up and cut that pass off.
Good pass by Henson to get it up to Goods.
Yes, it was, and it was nice. He knew he was going to take a hit for doing it, but he didn't care. He stood there, took it, made the pass.
Wagner and Poppers on a 2-on-1. Poppers with all the time in the world to shoot the puck, too.
Well, he tried to pick it up high, short side, but Jeff Marola wasn't having any of it.
Got that quick blocker on it.
Comes Carandang one more time over in the middle. Oh!
Katora looked like he had the third one there. I thought he was going to get it right under the pad.
It was set up for him, that's for sure, but he couldn't quite corral that bouncy puck. That's a good game. With John Marola for TSTV in conjunction with CMNtv, and we hope you enjoyed the broadcast.
Thank you very much, and have a great night, guys.